Good evening, Stephanie. Ethan Allen announced these layoffs back in June, but today was the end of an era for many who built their careers with the company.
The worst thing is, like, our kids and stuff, they wonder, you know, are we going to be able to stay here? And, you know, we really can't give them a straight answer.
In the tiny town of Beecher Falls, Ethan Allen is the only major employer. Many workers have been there since they graduated high school. But now the parking lot is empty as 250 employees struggle to figure out what's next.
I'm going to stick it out for a while and just hope that Ethan Allen does their part as far as giving us severance packages, that they honor that.
Jeff Gaudette is considering going back to school, but he's worried about his future.
There's no jobs out there no matter what you do. Even if you go to school, it's hard finding a job today. But
locals fear that the effects on the community could be devastating.
Car dealers are going to suffer. I'm sure banks are going to suffer because I'm sure a lot of people ain't going to be able to make their mortgage payments. I'm sure, you know, you get kids around here who want to go to college, and now the parents are going to figure out how they're going to come up with money for college.
It'll be, you know, it's going to be a trickle-down effect because, like, our schools and stuff, I mean, because right now we're having trouble because the numbers are down now, and I don't know what this is going to do. It's not going to help.
One manager said that some of the workers may be transferred to other plants, but with few options in the area, people will be faced with a tough decision of whether or not to leave their home.
I don't want to leave the area, but I will. I mean, I have to do what I have to do, but it's going to be devastating. I mean, no doubt about it.
About 80 employees will remain at that plant. Live in the Upper Valley Newsroom, Jackie Bender, News Channel 5.